absolutely fantastic to have you here. For people who aren't familiar with this timeless story, can you start by telling us just a little bit about the plot and about what excited you about the chance to be a part of bringing it to life on the screen?
Sure. It's about a woman called Emma Bovary. She marries young and sort of realizes that life isn't exactly what she expected it to be. So, yeah, it's great. I mean, it's based on a brilliant book of the same name, and you basically sort of witness a young woman's sort of descent. But yeah, she's not a typical hero.
How relevant do you feel it is to a contemporary audience?
Well, I always think that like things, or you know, books or whatever that are kind of classic literature, they continue to resonate, and there's some reason why people continue to read them. I don't entirely know what it is that brings people back to this book, but you know, I like that Emma's not a classic hero. She's very much like a she seems to divide people, and I think that that's an interesting conversation as to why it does.
Of course, you're no stranger to playing beloved figures from literature. Obviously, we love seeing you as Alice. I'm curious, does that carry an extra weight of responsibility, knowing you're playing a character that already has a place in people's hearts?
Yeah, definitely. But I guess you just try to sort of forget about it a little bit. I've been like so lucky to play these characters that I love, and yeah, try not to think about it too much, whose vision I'm destroying.
On the subject of Alice, obviously we're so excited to be getting the second film. Have you had a chance to chat to Tim about exactly what that'll involve? Because of course the first film kind of did something so new with the characters that we all know and love.
Yeah, I mean, we're shooting right now. James Boban is directing, and he's really brilliant, and it's been really good. It's really fun. It's nice to have the same cast and you know, to be sort of back with the same people, and yeah, it's fun.
I think Mia is the perfect Madame Bovary, because she has this capacity to transform from a very pure angelical character on screen to a very tormented, scary, almost monstrous woman, and she matures through the movie. So I think, you know, the ambiguity she brings on screen and all this very strong inner life she has is perfect for this role.
So, Madame Bovary is a story of Emma, who marries a country doctor, and it sort of follows her frustrations in this sort of rural life, really. And so it sort of follows her be sort of beguiled and enlisted by other characters and in the plot. It's brilliant. Mia is so wonderful in it. I play her maid. I play the maid of the house, so I sort of witness the tragedy unfold, really. I think it does, you know, follow a woman who in this time is sort of challenged by the lack of options she has, really. And, what does she do when she's stuck in a marriage that she's unhappy with? And she rebels and tries to find a more exciting and more romantic life for herself, which is exciting to watch and romantic and yet sort of tragic at the same time. So, yeah, I think there's lots in it. And Mia's wonderful in it.
So, I mean, you've been having a great time lately exploring kind of similar themes, I guess, on the new series of Downton. I mean, Edith and motherhood. I mean, it's I think, one of the most poignant aspects of the new season, Downton. Can you talk just briefly about working on that particular storyline?
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough series for Edith. She has her knocks here and there, but yeah, I think living sort of without her child is the worst it's got for her. And yeah, you'll have to see how it progresses. It's a really interesting storyline, and I feel very lucky to sort of tackle it, really.
Was it strange for you with this film going downstairs for a change?
Yes, it's much harder. You're in charge of like all the props when you're the servant. So I hope I pull it off.
What else have you got coming up?
I'm just starting a film called Burn, 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 which is a British comedy road trip movie. And I'm really looking forward to it.
Tell us any more about that. Who else is in it? What that's about?
So it's a modern day comedy. So girls on the road. Burn, Burn, Burn is a Kerouac quote. So yeah, but it's funny and a sort of British take on an American classic, I guess.
As a British star, what does it mean for you to be here at the BFI London Film Festival?
It's super exciting. I feel like it's a really good year, but I don't know if that's because I'm getting to be this side of it. It's really been exciting to be part of an exciting festival.